In 2015, scientists discovered the telltale signal from ripples of spacetime sweeping over the Earth. It was the very first direct detection of gravitational waves, generated by the merger of two massive black holes 1.3 billion light years away. This discovery was the culmination of decades of research and construction of huge instruments called interferometers to detect the warping of spacetime caused by gravitational waves. Today, the most advanced detectors, the LIGO-VIRGO collaboration, have turned up over 50 gravitational wave discoveries, on average one every week, allowing astronomers to perceive the universe in a completely different way. What new gravitational wave instruments are in the works, and what does the future hold for this relatively new field of study? Even though gravitational waves are generated by some of the most catastrophic events in the universe, like colliding black holes, exploding stars, and even the Big Bang itself, the size of these ripples is pretty small. It takes an incredibly sensitive instrument to perceive them at all. An early idea to detect the waves was to use laser interferometry. This is a technique where two lasers are merged together to create an interference pattern. The length of the lasers change as gravitational waves stretch and compress space itself, and this interference pattern changes in a measurable way. The first prototype gravitational wave detectors were built in the 1980s at various universities around the world, proving that all of the major engineering challenges of building a laser interferometer were solvable. Construction of the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, LIGO, began in 1994 at twin sites in Washington State and Louisiana. And in 2002, the observatories began searching the skies for gravitational waves. It didn't turn up anything for 8 years, getting shut down in 2010 for significant upgrades, leading to the next iteration, called Advanced LIGO. Finally, on September 14, 2015, the instruments made their first discovery of the merger between two 30-solar mass black holes. More upgrades were made to LIGO, and it was joined by the European VIRGO instrument in 2019, raising its sensitivity to the point that it could detect an average of one gravitational wave event every week. We're just a handful of years into the revolutionary science of gravitational waves, and with the successful discoveries under their belts, scientists and engineers are planning bigger and better experiments to detect even more gravitational waves with even more sensitivity. In the next couple of years, Japan will join the LIGO-VIRGO collaboration with its Kagra facility. This will add a fourth detector to the network, allowing scientists to track gravitational waves to their source with more accuracy. And just this year, India will begin the construction of their Indigo instrument to the growing worldwide network. What comes after that? It's called LIGO Voyager, and should be operational by the end of the 2020s. It will further improve the optics of the various LIGO facilities, reducing noise and increasing the sensitivity of its detections. If all goes well, the vastly upgraded facility should be capable of detecting collisions between neutron stars out to a distance of 3.6 billion light-years away, an increase of about a factor of 6. All of these improvements will come from better optics and measurement techniques, but to really improve the sensitivity of gravitational wave detectors, they'll need to increase the length of the arms of the instruments. A lot. LIGO uses arms which are 4 kilometers long, and lasers take hundreds of trips back and forth down the arms before they're merged together to detect the interference changes from gravitational waves. A new instrument under design in Europe is called the Einstein telescope, and would have 3 underground 10 kilometer arms arranged in an equilateral triangle, with 2 detectors at each corner. It's an ambitious design and could be completed and operational by the 2030s. Another concept in development is called the LIGO Cosmic Explorer. This would be a vastly scaled-up version of LIGO, with 40-kilometer-long arms, 10 times longer than the existing LIGO instruments. The first iteration, called CE1, could be operational in the 2030s, with the fully upgraded and enhanced CE2 making its observations in the 2040s. Cosmic Explorer should provide an order of magnitude more sensitivity than LIGO. It's estimated that it'll make millions of gravitational wave detections every year. Of these, hundreds of thousands will be stellar mass black hole mergers. In fact, astronomers will know of every single stellar black hole merger in almost the entire observable universe. It will also find unusual mergers that have never been detected so far, like a neutron star falling into an intermediate mass black hole, or a binary black hole surrounded by enough material that it could be visible to telescopes. It'll act like a finder scope to the extreme universe. Cosmic Explorer will be used to probe the structure of neutron stars, which contain the densest matter in the universe. In the final moments, as neutron stars are merging, they create a hot, dense remnant that emits both light and gravitational waves. By observing thousands of neutron star collisions, astronomers will better understand the structure of these exotic objects. One of the most exciting capabilities of Cosmic Explorer is that it will be able to provide an independent measurement of the geometry and expansion of the universe. This will provide astronomers with a completely new way to measure the Hubble parameter and calculate the amount of dark matter and dark energy in the universe. This is the instrument that might finally resolve the crisis in cosmology. And it won't just be collisions. Cosmic Explorer could directly detect the core collapse of massive stars in the Milky Way and nearby Magellanic clouds. It could find emissions from quakes in pulsars and glitches in magnetars. By partnering up with neutrino observatories like IceCube, it could help astronomers understand these extreme objects in more detail than ever thought possible. Of course, the most exciting discoveries made by any instrument will be the surprises. Detections of dark or exotic forms of matter interacting with black holes or neutron stars, or the mergers of primordial black holes formed at the beginning of the universe. Perhaps cosmic superstrings will give off emissions detectable by Cosmic Explorer. Once constructed, Cosmic Explorer will be a revolutionary advancement in the science of gravitational waves. But astronomers will want to detect with even longer arms, and to do that, we'll need gravitational wave detectors in space. I'll talk about that in a second, but first I'd like to thank Carter Fournier, Thomas Van Troyen, Bill Jackson, Greg Davis, Tyler Bell, and the rest of our 851 patrons for their generous support. Are you enjoying our videos? Well, that's all thanks to the patrons. We couldn't do it without them. Join our community at patreon.com/universetoday. The European Space Agency has already begun their plans to build a space-based gravitational wave detector. It's called LISA, or the Laser Interferometer Space Antenna. It'll consist of three detector spacecraft flying in perfect equilateral triangle formation, with arms 2.5 million kilometers long. LISA will work like an Earth-based gravitational wave detector, with lasers that cross through the vacuum of space to connect with each other. Each spacecraft contains two free-floating test masses, which are carefully monitored by the spacecraft. As gravitational waves sweep past the constellation, they make slight changes to the lengths of the laser arms, which will be detectable. With detection arms this long, LISA will be able to sense gravitational waves with much higher and much lower frequency than anything detectable from the surface of the Earth. One example is merging supermassive black holes. You'd expect these are easy to detect because of the millions and even billions of times the mass of the Sun that's involved. But these monsters actually merge relatively slowly. It will also give astronomers much more notice that merger events between stellar mass black holes are about to happen. Instead of that final whirling collision, LISA will sense the black holes orbiting around each other with several years' warning of their impending collision. It'll be able to sense how black holes are feeding from the environment around them, how they grow, and how they first formed early on in the universe. Previously hidden regions of the centers of galaxies or inside stellar nebulae will be revealed to LISA as it watches compact objects like neutron stars interact with black holes. LISA will discover compact binary systems where stellar remnants are orbiting each other like neutron stars, white dwarfs, and black holes. We know of a few dozen of these today, but LISA will find thousands. LISA is currently due to launch in 2034, which just sounds like forever. But good news, ESA has already taken a significant step forward with their LISA Pathfinder mission. This test mission launched on December 3rd, 2015, and was sent to test some of the technologies that will be used by the full LISA constellation. It carried two test masses that were balanced in freefall, linked by a laser interferometer. It then used micro-Newton thrusters to shift the spacecraft around them, keeping the test masses virtually motionless compared to each other. During the experiment run, LISA Pathfinder was able to keep the test masses perfectly balanced within the requirements for the full LISA mission. It was so sensitive that it had to account for the collisions of individual gas molecules in the test chamber, as well as cosmic rays, individual protons and neutrons that crashed into the test masses that the spacecraft had to compensate for. On June 30th, 2018, ESA shut down the LISA Pathfinder, shifting its focus to the full observatory. LISA is going to be a revolution in gravitational wave astronomy. But you know me, I always like to ask the question, what comes next? In the summer of 2019, a team of gravitational wave researchers came together to design a generic observatory that they could launch in the 2040s, which they called B-LISA. In this case, the mission would form an equilateral triangle orbiting the Sun at roughly the orbit of the Earth. Each arm in the interferometer would be 100 times longer than LISA's arms, over 150 million kilometers. Another idea would actually make the arms shorter than LISA, just 50,000 kilometers long, but give each spacecraft a much higher power laser as well as a 1 meter telescope to observe the lasers with incredible precision. The details are still being worked out. One of the biggest objectives will be to provide much better targeting for events. Right now, astronomers can know where a black hole collision happened in a rough region of the sky with an accuracy of a few degrees. This instrument would allow astronomers to know exactly which galaxy a black hole merger is happening in to give other astronomers a target for their telescopes. It would be able to sense double white dwarf systems for quite a while before their impacts, giving astronomers a huge warning of an impending Type 1a supernova. It would be able to find every intermediate mass black hole in the observable universe through their interactions with other compact objects and watch supermassive black holes consuming stellar mass black holes. It will identify hundreds of thousands of binary systems of all shapes and sizes throughout the Milky Way. A fascinating possibility will be to watch the first supermassive black holes in the universe as they pile on the mass, to watch how they went from millions of times to billions of times the mass of the Sun. The most extreme version of this telescope might allow astronomers to see beyond the cosmic microwave background radiation, a time so early in the universe that light itself couldn't escape. Gravitational waves could freely move during this time, and so these observatories could look right back to the very beginning of the universe itself, perhaps seeing evidence of inflation and helping astronomers understand the earliest moments of the cosmos. Although LIGO made its first direct detection of colliding black holes just a couple of years ago, astronomers have been dreaming about the possibilities of gravitational waves for decades. It's so exciting that we are now already at the point that collisions are now being detected every week or so, and it's inspiring to think how far the observatories and techniques could advance in the coming decades, and I can't wait to see how it all plays out. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Here are the names of the patrons who support us at the $10 level and more. Want to see your name here, support the work we do? Go to patreon.com/universetoday. Once a week, I gather up all my space news into a single email newsletter and send it out. It's got pictures, brief highlights about the story, and links you can find out more. Go to universetoday.com/newsletter to sign up. And did you know that all of my videos are also available in a handy audio podcast format so that you can have the latest episodes as well as special bonus material like interviews with me show up right on your audio device? Go to universetoday.com/audio or search for Universe Today on iTunes, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts, and I'll put a link in the show notes. We did a video about the changes scientists made to LIGO and VIRGO for the newest observing run and how it's making a new discovery every week on average, and you can watch that video next.